The sights, sounds, and struggles of a nation watching everything that had thawed freeze up again. As polar air plunges so far south, even Texas will feel the freeze. While out west tonight, a race is underway to get the sandbags in place before heavy rain threatens to bring mudslides down on thousands of homes. And ABC's meteorologist Ginger Zee is tracking the split personality weather for us tonight.
Parts of Southern California laying out almost 150,000 sandbags, preparing for what could bring more rain in 4 days than they've had in the past year.
Mudslides are more of a potential, especially in areas where there has been fires.
Especially in places like Glendora, California, home of that Colby wildfire that gnawed away at nearly 2,000 acres of vegetation in January.
We need the rain.
Well, I know, but not that much.
Yeah, not that much at once, but we do need the rain.
They need it to help dent that historic drought. But get this, even if they get 5 inches of rain, they'd need another 15 inches within a month to really see a rebound. Rain will start Wednesday, and the heaviest will come Friday into Saturday. In all, almost a half foot for some. Meanwhile, the headline for many east of the Rockies is cold. The savage winter still howling in southern Minnesota, where the deadline to get your ice fishing house off the lakes is less than a week away. But with all the cold and snow of late, they may not be able to remove them in time. That push of late February burr brings the sub-freezing wind chills as far south as North Texas and northern Alabama. The thaw-freeze effect forcing ice jams from Illinois to Indiana and Pennsylvania, bulldozing the swollen river's edge.
These chunks of ice out here, you know, are foot thick, and they're just destroying whatever they crossed.
There are wind chill advisories tonight through early tomorrow from Montana to Ohio. So let's bring back that polar map and show you the wind chill in Chicago, just one of the many cities that are concerned about the dangerous wind chill. By tomorrow morning, it'll feel like 20 below in Chicago. Other cities like Milwaukee, Des Moines, Detroit, anyone surrounding the Great Lakes, they're going to be very uncomfortable and close to dangerous, Diane.
All right. Thank you so much, Ginger Zee, reporting in.